March on, they call it.
Thank you. good evening.
So the dignitaries at the Bureau of Rwanda have just finished inspecting the ATL Navy Band.
And that is why we are here, because they delivered on their promise in short. Before we proceed with the program, I have just been informed that the traditional council is ready to come take their seat. So traditional council of my Hene of the Atlantic Hall, please Nana, the floor is yours. Fidel and his administration, and that is why we are here, because they delivered on their promise in short. Before we proceed with the program, I have just been informed that the traditional council is ready to come take their seat. So traditional council of my Hene of the Atlantic Hall, Please, Nana, the floor is yours.
All right.
and his administration, and that is why we are here, because they delivered on their promise, in short. Before we proceed with the program, I have just been informed that the traditional council is ready to come take their seat. So, traditional council, Omahene of the Atlantic Hall, please, Nana, the floor is yours. Thank you.
sits on the high table. The Nano, the chief and the queen mother. Fellow mariners, good evening to everyone. Today happens to be a very joyous day. In fact, we are about to record history tonight. I've always said, since the beginning of this administration, that although this administration is happening within bad times, it's not going to be under this administration that we are going to halt the tradition of the hall. Regardless of the time we find ourselves in, the hall tradition must go on. So, tonight, as part of our plan to reignite the tradition of the hall, we gathered here to officially unveil that which symbolizes what makes ATL ATL. I'm giving the singular honor to give the welcome address for tonight's program. So on behalf of my executives and the whole council, I'd like to welcome each and everyone for partaking in this program. All the alumni bodies who are doing their service, who are working, that left their workplaces to be part of this program, I'd like to welcome all of you. In fact, those who have missed lectures to be part of this program, the executive say welcome. And we hope you enjoy the program. Thank you so much.
Two more for Fidel, Anna. Four more for Fidel. But say Fidel, they didn't have five. 85 more for Fidel. Okay. Thank you so much, Mr. Osei Agyemang, for giving us the welcome address. At JCRC, when you put up an idea, if you do not have someone up there who believes in your idea, you could be stifled and then your followers could think you are not working. But considering my close ties with the JCRC, it has been evident that the support of this person I'm about to introduce is one of the reasons why we are here today. If you didn't support this vision, the finances to rebuild the monument there would never have happened. So, fellow mariners, this person I am talking about is... Hey. I don't want to try anymore. But he is a senior lecturer at the department. Okay. I'm actually about to be corrected. Okay, I have been corrected, please. I'll ask you later. He is an associate professor with the Department of French. He is currently the hall master of the Great Atlantic Hall. And by the time he leaves here, he would have another position, which we will announce later. Fellow mariners, with a round of applause, a very big one, a standing ovation, I present to you the chairperson of the occasion, Professor Maulo Kofi Koda. Please let me welcome for Hall Master, please. Prof, thank you so much. Please, our chairperson, would like to hear your...
It's a great moment for us. Reconcile to our roots. And I'm happy that this is happening today. So I will allow the MC to carry on the program. And we see the manifestation of what happened later. Thank you very much for this.
Thank you so much.
Much as it is difficult to understand the rationale behind such happenings among university students, it is important to continue to engage the student leadership across the halls of residents to sensitize their constituents on the need to ensure peaceful and harmonious coexistence among students on campus and beyond. A conducive environment is a prerequisite for teaching and learning. This is not negotiable. To attain this, there is the need for collaboration and cooperation among all the segments of the university community. We must all, therefore, rally around a common vision and mission statement of the University of Cape Town, so as to work assiduously towards achieving the ideals of the founding father of our institution. May I, at this point, congratulate the whole president and his team for the great work done to rehabilitate our great hall by mending the broken fences they inherited. It adds to the legacies and achievements of this administration. Mr. Hall President, the history book of Atlantic Hall will graciously be enriched by new pages of great achievements in which your name and the names of members of your team will be duly acknowledged and accorded all the honors due heroes and great achievers. Congratulations. May I use this historic occasion to also announce to my fellow mariners my new appointment as head of department of French with effect 1st August. I will therefore unfortunately cease to be Hall Master of Atlantic Hall by close of day tomorrow, July 31, 2021. My life as an academic has been determined by my history and association with this great hall. I came in here as a student and I went out as a lecturer. I came in here as a doctor and I'm going out as a professor. To God be the glory. I thank you all for the support you gave in the course of my 1 year administration of the hall. Continue to maintain your high sense of discipline and fraternity in the hall. Always be mindful of the need to work together in peace and harmony for the collective good. Together we stand, divided we fall. Cherish and jealously guide our gates at all times. Keep the hall clean and lively in all your dealings. Long live Marines, long live Marine City, long live UCC, long live Ghana. Thank you very much. And may the good Lord continue to bless you as you continue to grow together. I love you all.
I'm sure you have seen or heard of the big announcement. Anyone heard of the big announcement? Okay. So, for about 2 weeks now, there has been a trending campaign of the big announcement. Today, we make the big announcement. And to do as I honor, I invite once again the president of the Republic of Atlantic Hall, Fidel Osei Agyemang, to give us the big announcement.
Thank you so much. I'm back once again. It's in fact an honor announcement. But before that, I'd like to invite my vice president to join me. So, there's a saying that behind every successful man. Behind every successful man, there's a big woman. So, all this has been made possible with the support of our hardworking vice president. So, and we know that once someone stands out to work very hard with position giving, it's important that we push the person to a higher position. So, this year's election, we are pushing an 8-year agenda this year. And as part of the 8-year agenda, in solidarity, we are supporting our vice president as she acts or play the role of the running mate to Team Decider. Please, can Team Decider join me? So, on behalf of the student of UCC, I present to you Team Decider for SRC presidency. So, Marines, this is a very personal agenda. So, let's all rally behind our vice president and Mr. Decider to be the next president of the SRC. And we are very confident that with the support the vice president has given me, she's going to give similar support to Mr. Decider, and together they can push the interests of students at the SRC level. Thank you so much.
Related by this introduction, I must say, and it's a public knowledge, that I'm a custodian. The 50th president of CASCO. Because of that, I have a strong appreciation of the difference that exists between the superpowers of the University of Cape Coast, i.e. Mariners and Cascodians. But there should be a time when the two great halls would come together, work together, reason above the differences that exist between the two great halls. And I believe and have a strong conviction that the time is now. And it's on this singular basis that in the choice of my running mates to contest you for the position of SRC presidency, I came to the Marine City to choose the current vice president of the JCRC as the running mate and hopefully the vice presidential candidate, and subsequently to get to be the vice president of SRC. I want to thank you for the fervent support you have given to Team Decider, and as you go to fight for the presidency, we'll do all it takes to win the victory for us all. Thank you very much for the support.
Thank you so much. So it's official. Team Decider for SRC president.
Myself is a moderate.
Ensure. Ensure. Ni baby a extra on toa. On kanta a woman de pa. Enapa. I go to cherry. Sign your button.
I'm a fan.
500. But you better not sign a check. We have a problem. Check is allowed. Tell that a bouncer, a local court, and have ordered us. I have court. Aluminum for now, mobile.
Come on. give you.
What do you mean?
The sculpture here symbolized in the life of an Atlantic student or Atlantic Hall student in the University of Cape Coast.
Thank you very much. Like any monument, our monument has history. A history depicting the African mother who is caring, who is loving, and therefore will support the children no matter what happens, will fend for their needs, come what may, raining or shining, sea carrying water, doing all works in order to get them their livelihood, in sustaining them. So this monument is representative of such a symbolic African mother who is indeed working to sustain the children. And therefore, Hollers have some affinity to this monument. And that is why, following its destruction as a result of the clash between Ogwa and Atlantic Hall a year ago, we decided at the hall management level to have it constructed. Much as the university management was taking steps to get maybe people who were involved to pay for this, we could not wait because our spirit has been broken and there is a need for the reconstruction of the spirit, which is the life wire of the hall. So this has been the motivation for us with the new JCRC leadership to get this thing reconstructed and rehabilitated, bringing us to this day of unveiling it publicly.
All right, thank you very much, Prof. This being a special occasion in the life of every affiliate of the Atlantic Hall of the University of Cape Coast, what is your advice to the students who are watching us?
Thank you. My advice to them is that university life is a preparation for life ahead of us. We are here to study, we are here to be nurtured so that we can be in harmony with nature, which is our maker, who loves order, who loves harmony. And therefore, conflicts that will lead to destruction of things that we have put money into should be avoided. We can play, we can have fun, but that should not lead to destruction. There should be a kind of love between all students across the university, because we need that to rally around the visions and mission statement of the university, to build an environment that will lead to training people that will come out with minds that will help to build a sustainable country, for that matter, a sustainable humanity. It is my dream and it is my wish for all Hollers to have in mind the need for peaceful coexistence in the community and also to work towards achieving a conducive environment for learning and teaching to take place effectively. They should eschew all manner of hooliganism that will be destructive and lead to financial loss to our state. We don't have enough resources. Therefore, the little we have, we should invest them into sustainable businesses, not in destruction. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Prof. God bless you for your time.
You're welcome, and thank you for the honor. Thank you for coming to cover this event for us. We are really, really grateful. And God bless you all.
God bless you, Prof.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hello.
May I know your name?
Yeah, I'm Pascal.
Oh, okay, nice. The way you are repping your Atlantic Hall, I can see the power is really in.
Yeah, strong.
Oh, okay. So today being the commissioning of the great Atlantic Hall statue, like, I think you were expecting some things. And what went on? Did you really witness those expectations?
Yeah, I was very happy because people came in their numbers, and then the drama, cadets, everything, the hall masters, Charlie, everything went well. I'm very happy.
Oh, okay. I'm also glad it went well for you. And I think there's a morale, something going inside. And the heat I'm feeling already, I can feel like you are going to participate.
Yeah, that was our first morale, Sparismo, you see that thing. So we are going to rep 24-7, you day. Beka TV, no go finish, you see that thing.
May I know your name?
My name is Benjamin Nchi.
That's, is it?
Most people call me Nana Kwame.
Okay, so I also call you Nana Kwame. Okay, Nana Kwame, like what's going on here? Here today is the commissioning of the ATL statue. What's really going on tonight?
Well, as you already said, today is we are commissioning the statue. So as you can see, we are all gathered here. Yeah. And we hope for the best, I think, here.
Okay, so this evening's morale, like, what? Because I'm feeling the heat already.
Oh, and that year, umpire, Ibija. The only person I can say, cast for no Munjina.
My name is Achanwamua Gideon.
Oh, Gideon, so I can call you Gideon.
Yeah, popular as Kobe Major. Kobe Major.
Oh, okay. So your outfit, you really look good in your outfit.
Yeah, sure. As you can see, I'm with my Lacoste, ATL Lacoste, with a band showing that in truly I'm a Marina.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice. So what's going on tonight with the morale and all that?
As you can see, a lot of people are around. ATL we rule. Okay, so whenever you hear that there is going to be a morale, you see that all the Nsamanfo, that I can say, yeah, Nsamanfo in Ebefi, and it's really going to be an exciting one. The boys are with all vim, with all that enthusiasm, and we are really happy to have this morale.
Oh, okay, I can't wait to see you inside there, the way you'll be moving and singing. Yeah.
Sure, I'm a Marina indeed. I'm a true Marina, and we are here to do the fireworks, everything, and we are going to do everything possible to show that indeed we are Marinas.
Okay, I like your impatcho fabos, mami. Thank you for being here with
me. I'm Claudia.
Oh, okay, nice name. So like tonight, what's going on? Like I can feel your dressing tells it all, but I want to hear more from you.
Oh, today yeah, me personally, like I am here for the morale, but like you see, it's not just the morale. It's about the opening of the abaya and everything. So yes, I'm here for almost. I'm prepared, like ready for everything.
Wow, I like your vim. So like, I hope to see you participating in the morale because me, I'll be there. I'll be doing things. So you, what's up?
Charlie, me, I did. I hope say you did too. Yeah. So come make me vibe, okay?
Thank you very much. I'm Philip Akwabonzi, and I'm currently the ATLFA chairman in my final year, level 400.
Okay, it's cool to have one of the organizers around. So what really went into the organization?
Oh, wow. Currently, just as we all got to understand during the day, we made known that we are going to unveil our reconstructed Mother Atlantic and Kofi Atlantic. So basically, the executive and another stakeholder came together to make this program a success, just as you also.
So in every program, when you are organizing, there are some expectations to be met and all that. Did you guys really meet your expectations?
Yeah, I would say we really met our expectation because we are really noted to be those kind of wars, or one of the wars that basically engages in brutalities. But here is the case, by God's grace and with the effectiveness in the organization of the JCRC in collaboration with the whole management, came to realize that there wasn't any such eventuality that happened during the ceremony or the activity. So we say since there was peace and then there was order during the ceremony or the unveiling of Mother and then Kofi Atlantic, I would say we really met our expectation.
Okay, so to brush it all up, it means you are expecting unity, and by God's grace, you had it. Thank you very much for being on this program with us.
Thank you very much.
Yahya Abdel Karim. My friends call me Decider, former Vice President of Castford, currently the Speaker of Parliament for UCC Students Parliamentary Council, and aspirant for SLC Presidency.
Okay, so today you came down from Castford to ATL, which is kind of strange. So like, what were your expectations, and were your expectations met at this program?
In fact, I'm elated to say that indeed it's the big announcement. We came to unveil the big announcement in respect of my choice of running mate from the Marine City. You know, there has been differences between Casford and ATO, but I think that it's about time that we reason beyond the difference in the interest of colleague students. So when it got to the point that I had to select my running mate, I settled on 8-year hall. So when I was coming here, I was expecting something great, and indeed it was greater when the euphoria around it and everything was very positive, because I believe that the colleagues are starting to appreciate the fact that we need to come together and do something positive in the interest of the students' front. So that is what exactly translated into today's meeting, or the agenda that transpired today.
Okay. I'm being very curious here, because upon all the people, you came down to ATL to select someone, a mariner. So I think it's fishy. So can you please elaborate more on it?
There's nothing fishy. If there's anything to think about, it is just for the student front to be united. Casford and ATL for some time now, we have been engaging in so many things that someone would say it's uncalled for. But I believe that aside the differences, we can come together, do something in the interest of colleague students. That is my basic motivation for coming to ATL in the choice of running mate. And they have appreciated it, and they are in support of it fully. And today the occasion was also to unveil or commission their abaya, the statue, which came as a result of the demolition of an existing one. And today they rebuilt it, and we had to commission it. It's also the old one got destroyed because of this same student clashes and all of that. So I think it's about time the student front got united, we came together, and make sure that we do something positive for ourselves.
Okay, so from what you're saying, the key aim of you coming down to Marine City to get someone as your, let me say, running mate, it's just for unity, if I'm correct.
Exactly. The student front must be united, and that is the step I have taken. And I believe that the student populace will support it. Because there's a saying that if the student front is divided, it is the politician who benefits. We don't stand to gain anything. So we don't have to let our fronts divide. Let us stay united, stay focused to the cause, and I believe that the student front tomorrow will be better.
Okay, thank you very much for being part of our program. Thank you.
You're welcome, and I'm grateful. Thank you for having me.
I'm Della.
Oh, okay, nice name. Where are you coming from?
Oh, I'm from Indu. Yeah.
Oh, nice. So what's really going on out here? What is going on?
Oh, today it was the commissioning of the so that's why we are here, to witness it. So
I think there's a morale, something going. I can see some jumping and jubilation and things. So like, what are you going to participate in the fest?
Of course. Hey, we are from Indumo, Chale. So the Germana that we the wed.
We there inside. Sure. Okay, so as you are going back to campus, what do you have to tell our fellow people out there?
Charlie, ATL is the best, so ATL no size.